Donna Bush with your CID TV News Brief on this Monday evening. Recently, hazard management staff was busy training the Cayman Islands Regiment team on what to do at shelters across the Cayman Islands should we be hit by a disaster and need to open shelters for residents.
The shelter operation consists of getting teams, volunteers, a part of this umbrella and having that clear understanding of what to do if there's an emergency. So in this shelter management training, what we normally do, we try to house two training sessions. Currently, we did one last week with the regiment, and that was 44 volunteers. But overall, the shelter management operations or the training, it involves getting these individuals trained, have an understanding of the procedures, the tools, the equipment that's at our shelters. And right now, as it stands, hazard management has 19 of the islands. So one in Little Cayman, three in Cayman Brac, and 15 here in Grand Cayman. So that is just one element of what we do for in hazard management. But what we try to do, we heavily invest ourselves in the mitigation and the preparedness element of it, because we're strong believers that if you're prepared for it, you will understand your risks and you know your hazards and you find some ways to mitigate all that situation.
If you would like to be a shelter volunteer, you're encouraged to contact HMCI for the criteria as well as the training information. West Bay Health Clinic parking lot, the West Bay Health Clinic parking lot is being repaved. So if you're going to the clinic, be aware of the temporary parking spaces that are next to the Sir John A. Cumber Primary School. The closure of the clinic's parking lot started today, the 11th of July. The Health Services Authority is apologizing for any inconvenience by the project, but it is to enhance the facility for a better patient experience. Santa Victoria. A school leaving and prize giving ceremony was held recently for students from Creek and Spot Bay Primary Schools on Cayman Brac. Parents, teachers, and dignitaries were on hand to witness and congratulate the graduates who will now go on to high school.
I am equally delighted and elated to see the theme that you've chosen for this year. Small town kids, big city dreams. And as I contemplated what to speak to you on this morning, it would be entirely remiss of me if I did not use a Spot Bay example.
Minister O'Connor Connolly went on to tell the story of a well-known Cayman Bracker having big dreams. The event was held at the Cayman Brac Multipurpose Hall on June the 27th. Turning to our forecast, it calls for partly cloudy skies with a 30% chance of late night showers tonight. The two-day outlook is for similar weather conditions through to Wednesday afternoon. Now, the synopsis calls for light southeasterly winds and seas, which will continue across the Cayman Islands area for the next 24 hours. It is due to a weak pressure gradient across the Caribbean region. A reminder that you can find the latest on local weather conditions online at weather.gov.ky. And that's it for today's news brief here on CID Television. I'm Donna Bush. As always, thanking you for joining us, wishing you a safe and wonderful night, and of course, inviting you back here again on Tuesday evening. Bye-bye for now.
Seek the latest accurate information on COVID-19 only from official sources at gov.ky/coronavirus.